25, 30 years. This dude been down 25, 30 years. He seen a murder in jail. So he jumped on it because they was talking about giving him a time reduction. So he jumped on it. He been in jail like 25, 30 years. So I asked him, I said, why don't you tell, man? He said, let me tell you something. I had life in prison. He said, I woke up 30 years later and found out that I ain't never do a day.
What do you mean by that? What do you mean that he ain't never do a day?
That means if you got natural life in prison and you wake up 30 years into that bed, what difference does it make? You're never going home.
Right.
You understand?
Right, and realize he ain't never did a day.
It's like he never did a day.
Right, okay.
Every day he wakes up, it's not like if he had 50 years and he did 30 already, so he can say, well, I got 20 more. He did 30, and he still got life.
Right.
So he said, youngster, I seen a murder. They asked me about it. They was talking about giving some time reduction. Oh, I jumped on it.
Now he's home or coming home?
Well, no, I never knew what happened to him because I left the county jail.
But that just stuck with you.
That just stuck with me to say to myself, hey, he woke up 30 years later.
Was it the guys that you ran into when you first were beginning to think about that?
Right, these were guys that I ran into in my the beginning of my decisions as far as what should I do and, you know, am I doing the right thing or are people going to be mad at me and all that.
Right.
And I truly thought about that, like, are people going to be mad at me? But then people like Rafe came across my head. People like Jack came across my head. The old dude came across my head. The young dudes before me that went to trial, that, you know, strapped up their nuts, went before me and came back with natural life and all that. I ain't going to that.
Natural life
in prison. I'm 24, 25 years old. I couldn't even, you know, as tough and as wild and free as I ran the streets and didn't care about nothing. Once I was in this predicament, I couldn't do it, Antoine. I couldn't see myself in prison, but I also looked at people like Nicky. Dudes like Nicky came across my mind, like how he put in 20 years for dudes who didn't care nothing about him and all that. And then I look at a person like Guy Fisher who had it all. Now he's doing natural life in prison. And he got this girl out here who he probably took care of, you know, while they were together. And she's doing her thing and she's having problems getting up to Pennsylvania to go see him or whatever. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
You know, I talked to him on the phone. You know, he was happy to, one day I was at our house and I asked the phone. And he was happy not to hear from me, but he was happy to know that he remembered what they did to Nicky, that he was happy just to hear that I wasn't one of his friends boning his girl.
Right.
Because he was like, yo, who's this? I was like, this is Alpo, man. He was like, oh, yeah, I heard about you. I said, yeah, because his daughter, I was hitting his daughter, too.
Okay.
And he said, yeah, I heard about you. Yeah, I heard you messing with Renee. And then I said, yeah, man, you know, I'm here. This, that, if you know, you ever want to call here, if you need something, whatever. He was like, nah. He said, I'm just happy to know that it ain't one of my friends.
That ain't one of his friends?
Yeah. Because he was one of Nicky's friends, and they was all hitting Nicky's girls.
Did you have any problems like that when you called from prison to speak to some of maybe your baby's mothers or any of their boyfriends?
No.